vehicle bearing LRD Nissan 9650, Northeast 1C on Wyoming and West 4, repeating all 4 subjects are in custody at Wyoming West 4. They do have an SUNS on scene.
I was thinking, this is bullshit. I it should have took me this long to respond. I should have just walked across the road. I should have just walked across to the other house. Man, oh shit. That was a false. It was a false alarm. Yeah, accidental medical alarm activation. And they didn't have their damn door locked. I had to open up the door. Yeah, I had to open up the door and yell for them. They're like, yeah, who's this? Oh yeah, they were sleeping. They could barely hear me. You know, I hate doing that, but you know, you got to do it, and you know, and it's got to be scary for them. You know, all of a sudden, someone's yelling up the stairs. Oh, the police department. Yeah, it's upstairs. Yeah, it's right when you walk in the door. You have stairs to your left. Yeah. So, walked up, but it says, okay if I come up? I'm like, yeah. So, he must have rolled on top. He's got one around his neck. He's got a little medical alert necklace. He must have rolled on top of some Combs residents, Henry and Mary Combs. I said, do you guys want me to lock your door? She's like, no, the cops are always up here anyway, so I'm not too worried. I know she did. I know I am funny. That was the basketball game. Wow, what did you score? All 12 points? Wow. Always a good feeling. Yeah. Congratulations. Tom, good job for me. Okay. Sorry to bug you last night. I felt like I was being selfish last night. Damn it, I went Miami time. Okay. Good, because I really enjoyed it. That is true. That was kind of a deep conversation for us.
All right.
I'll have to tell you my little cheesy fantasy then, too. My cheesy fantasy is for Frontier Days, we're all there. We have our uniform inspection. We have a couple of things they ask us, you know, about policy and procedure, and you know, make sure all your equipment's good and you look good. And we eat our food, and Chief goes over a few things, which is probably more than he does with the council. And he's like, well, Officer Kane needs to announce something to you guys. You know,
obviously, we had already talked about this, me and you, and we talked to Chief about this. And
he just, I got up and I said, now, as you guys know, I'm going through a divorce. And I said, but I want to let you guys know that I was seeing someone else, and you might have to field questions from it every now and then. And you're probably thinking to yourself, well, God, who the hell's he dating, the mayor? And I'm like, well, by the way, I'm dating the mayor. That's my little cheesy moment with you. Yeah. And of course, everyone's there, you know, including Butch. You know how Butch would get. She didn't tell me. What do you think of that? What do you think of that, little boy? I think it's something you didn't know. Yep. Of course, Bob West, like, way to go, my boy. It's
what he would say. Everyone else is just like, oh my God. Man, how do you get that trophy? Yeah. Oh. The guy that Gary arrested last night, he blew a 236.236. The video is hilarious. It is hilarious. I'm just like, I can't. He dropped someone off on Sycamore and then was heading back up. That's when he got clocked. But he didn't get clocked. He almost hit Paul. That's what it was. Something like that. Now, he lives up in the township. The guy on Sycamore, according to Paul, it looks like he's had some pipes up him before. They were kind of femmy guys. So, but I told him, I said, man, keep it all in Mayor's Court. There's no reason to give the county all this money. And open container, fleeing and eluding, Mark Lanes, high tier OBI. So that'll be pled down to a first offense. Low tier test. So that's money. Money. It's money. Yep. And my guy complimented Jamie how professional I was. Yeah. Then I stopped one of Hodges' women. Deborah Lyons. I guess it's Dookie Jackson's sister. Yeah, she lives on 3 High Street. And you know what? As soon as I start talking to her, I thought of you. Because I saw her on High Street going across Latitudes. I'm like, it's 3:30 in the morning. The only ones on High Street are drunks. So I turn around to get the plate, and then it turns onto Mill Street, and then goes right up onto a driveway behind those houses on 3 High Street. Right by the hair stylist place, Gay Hearts or something. Yeah. And she gets out of the car, and I'm thinking, oh, I got this girl. I mean, there's no way she lives here. She's trying to hide from me. So I'm like, I said, ma'am, I said, how are you? She's fine. Is there a problem? I said, do you live here? She said, yeah, I do. This is my mom's house. I'm like, oh, okay. And I start running her plate, and she goes, you must be Russ. And I'm like, yeah. She's like, she's like, I'm one of Hodges' friends. I'm like, oh, help. My job's done. She goes, oh, no. He talked to me a while back about being a drinker for one of your classes. I'm like, oh, yeah. And I'm thinking, I bet you called Hodges to see if he was working tonight. And he's sitting down, the damn Russ Kenny's working. Yeah. And she's like, no. I was going to try to drink for you one day when you were trying to find drinkers, because I was hurting for drinkers. I couldn't find them. Everyone that I had coming to drink kept backing out on me. I was like, you got to be shitting me. You know? The thing is that they can't eat. We start drinking at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Your last meal has to be done at 1 o'clock. You don't eat anything before then, and then we start boozing you up for 3 hours. And then, you know, from 6 to whenever you do the field sobriety test, then I take everyone home. I probably got another one coming up in the spring. I wouldn't mind doing another one for our department, but I don't know if we can swing it with the training budget. So I'd like to do one for the whole county. You gotta drink liquor. Pretty much. Because it's, I like whiskey. Whiskey, rum, vodka. I have a whole bottle that hasn't even been opened of absolute vodka. Getting your goose on. Shit, that'll go over real good. Nope, got my own, Russ. I'm just going to pour myself. Yeah, you're already be dosed up before I get you. I don't use cops, and I don't use cops wise. So I do
says, what if I'm dating her? Yep, that's my little cheesy fantasy, is telling everyone at Pioneer Valley Days I'm dating you.
I think Frontier Days, which is first part of June, I think, you know, you'll have a lot of your things taken care of. I'm going to have a lot of my things taken care of. I think it's just a matter of waiting for dates. You know, and I think that would be, because there's no way I can hold off that long. No way. Well, I mean, you know, that was just my cheesy fantasy, you know. It's not like, you know, not like that it would take that long, but, you know, if we were smart about it, you know, that would be a good time, because it's, you know, it's almost a whole year, a whole half a year, you know. So... No, that's it. So we'll just have to take it, you know. But that. Did you get any sleep last night? What's that? Yeah, so am I. What? Sorry. When I got to bed, I had that big old body pillow. I held it close. I just closed my eyes and really pretended it was you. Yeah. Really just closed my eyes. Yeah, I fell asleep. I woke up about 12. I knew I had to get up at 12:30. So I'm like, I fucking might as well shower. The pillows don't quite have the sex occurs that your body does. Nor is it real hot. Nor does it smell real well. No. Nope. Nor does it feel like you when I press up against it.
Bruise your pelvis bone. Or your pubic bone.
Now that's hot. That's hot. That is hot. Surprised there's no dent in your refrigerator. Two ass cheeks.
Well, I bet you did.
Good thing you hadn't done any real renovation in that kitchen.
That's what Karen Huff is telling me.
Two things. Oh, it must be these little apartments.
Yeah.
There's two of them.
Yeah. Drive down there, they see my presence.
Oh, they're always down past me.
Yeah, they're always up to take a look.
Up to?
You know, you can always play a game with that.
I could hide somewhere, and I could kind of give you hints where I'm at.
I have a distinct car, don't I? really think if you really... Oh, boy. Okay. Do you really think if you rode around, hey, we'd try to be stopping everywhere and screaming? I'll tell you what. Yeah, that's true. I can always show you the spot that we think people might be screaming at. And then I can show you how sometimes I find people screaming. Probably good. Walk out from me, brother. Main Street. Going past the Dreamers. I'm the only one. When I work, I'm the only one that has a Dodge, day or night, on my rotation. It really is. I have a lot more room. I have more headroom. I have more leg room. The back's got way more room than a Crown Vic. Yep, it's got a lot more room. It's a lot better car. These are better cars. These are better than the Ford. I think the Ford. I know. Look at how badass looking car. Looks like a nice job of design. Get a lot of compliments. Adds to my ego. Well, I'd like to have your legs wrapped around my waist. Or my shoulders. Don't bother me. Yeah. Yeah.
Bet you could. I've seen your legs.
Mel Gibson, Road Warrior, Mad Max, you know, Beyond Thunder Dome. You know what was on when I was getting ready for work? John Wayne Realoma. With Dean Martin in it. Oh, yeah, I can, but no, I have the video. It's one of those movies that AMC just kind of shows on a regular basis for a while, then they start showing something else on a regular basis. Yeah.
And I'm thinking, man, it's kind of rainy out, it's cold, I stay in bed, snuggle up to somebody.
I've seen you in a lot of different clothes. I like every single look that you put out there. Every look.
Doesn't matter to me.
I said I can look at you all day and not be bored. Nope. Nah, let's not go there yet. I'm getting close to that point, but let's not go there yet.
it just kind of sounds like you're, you know, you're real comfortable with me right now. And so, just, you know, really leads to, you know, some deep feelings for you. I think you have the same feelings I am. I hope. And we'll leave it at that for now. Like you said too. Alright. Maybe I'll see you around. Yeah, I'm running a traffic car. You could always do something stupid, like run a stop sign or stop light or something like that to stop you. Really? Well, that is a stoppable offense in the city of Milford. You don't happen to have any contraband in your car or on you, do you? I don't know. You might be. Oh, I can do that. I'd like to do the little thing for you. God, we got to end this conversation. I can think of a lot of little things I like doing to you. Involving my tongue, my lips, my fingers, my hands. All right. I got to be productive today. 4 hours. All right, man. Call me later.